Good day and welcome to Mission Control Houston, where the team of flight controllers is watching over systems aboard the International Space Station as it travels about 230 statute miles over the eastern coast of the United States. On duty today as the flight director in charge is Emily Nelson with Shannon Lucid, a veteran astronaut serving as a spacecraft communicator, talking to the Expedition 29 crew aboard the International Space Station. Of course, that's Commander Mike Fossum and Flight Engineer Sergei Volkov and Satoshi Furukawa. Of course, Volkov from the Russian Federal Space Agency and Furukawa from the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency, two of the key partners for NASA on this orbiting outpost, along with the European Space Agency and the Canadian Space Agency. Today has been a day for these three crew members devoted primarily toward preparation for the arrival of new crew members and for their departure. The newest members of the crew are scheduled to launch from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan late the evening of November 14th, Houston time. That'll be Dan Burbank, the future commander of the space station, along with Anatoly Ivanishin and Anton Shkaplerov. Two of the Russian crewmates are going to be joining these existing three crew members for a relatively short handover period. The handover period only about 6 days long because of the delay in launch of the next three crew members following failure of one of the Progress launch vehicles, which had some similarities to the Soyuz rocket that will be used to launch those crew members. The Russian team in the Russian Federal Space Agency and their contractors have done a thorough review of the cause of that and determined it was some debris in one of the fuel lines. They had a successful launch of the Progress 45 spacecraft, which has arrived at the International Space Station and is in the process of being unloaded, and have reported in today's flight readiness review conducted here at the Johnson Space Center in Houston by mission managers led by Bill Gerstenmaier, the head of human spaceflight operations for NASA, that everything is looking good for the upcoming launch of the remaining three crew members and the return of Fossum, Furukawa, and Volkov back home to Earth after their 6 months on orbit. Among the things the crew did today, in addition to preparing for their departure and the arrival of their new crewmates, was to do a reconfiguration of some power systems. They did a jumper installation on a Destiny Laboratory secondary power distribution system to add some additional redundancy to the power systems on the space station. They have been noticing some irregularities in the signals from one of the main bus switching units. There are four of these that are located on the S0 part of the truss. That's where the truss connects to the Destiny Laboratory module. And just to provide the maximum redundancy of that switching unit, which routes power throughout the space station, they installed a jumper inside the lab, and that all has been completed well. Crew also today did some experiment work. One of the experiments that they worked on was called SODI by its nickname, which stands for Selectable Optical Diagnostics Instrument, and it's an aggregation of colloidal solutions. Colloidal solutions are those like paint where you have solids that are suspended within the liquid, and this particular experiment studies how those kinds of colloids aggregate or mass within the liquids on board in the microgravity environment. One of the most promising applications of this kind of colloidal engineering is the fabrication of photonic devices. These devices have to have structures whose scale length is comparable to the wavelength of light and that are ordered in all three dimensions. Gravity plays a disturbing role in the development of these on the Earth, and so these space experiments are looking at how we can improve on those materials. Satoshi Furukawa was the main person working on those activities today. And you can see him in these live downlinks as he's working with the setup of some of the optical equipment that's associated with that SODI experiment. Also on tap today were some routine water processing apparatus activities by Commander Mike Fossum. Fossum was working on doing the topping off of a water recovery system waste storage tank. That's the tank that stores the brine from the water recovery system on the International Space Station, which recycles human waste, urine, and eventually turns it into pure drinking water that can be used by the crew for a variety of purposes, including meal preparation, hygiene, and other uses on board the space station. Some pretty spectacular views coming down of the eastern coast of the United States and Canada over Newfoundland as the International Space Station orbits about 230 statute miles over the Canadian partner in the International Space Station effort. Fairly cloudy up there as winter begins to set in. But overall, all systems on the International Space Station functioning very well as we get ready for the arrival of a new set of crew members scheduled to launch from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan on November the 13th. That's going to be a Sunday night here in Houston at 10:14 p.m. Central Time. It'll actually be just opposite on the clock at the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan, so it'll be a daytime launch. And then they'll be docking their spacecraft to the Poisk module of the space station at 11:33 p.m. Central Time on November the 15th. And that will round out the crew to six people once again, but only for 6 days while they conduct a rapid handover before Fossum and his colleagues Furukawa and Volkov return home to Earth after the end of their six-month stay on orbit. Change of command ceremony from handing over command from Fossum to Burbank is scheduled for Sunday, November 20th. That change of command ceremony expected about 2 p.m. Central Time. This is Mission Control Houston.